Vsauce, Kevin here. On November 15th, 1912, an innocent family moved into a large rambling house with narrow windows seemingly incapable of welcoming the sun's rays. Soon after, the sound of a door slamming shut by itself and footsteps inside the walls terrified the parents. The children heard voices. Someone or something called out from beyond, and all the plants withered and died. This house truly was haunted by carbon monoxide. The furnace was broken, filling the entire home with poisonous gas, causing headaches, dizziness, and auditory hallucinations. But not ghosts. What the fack? The facts and knowledge on not so real ghosts. A legendary ghost ship known as the Flying Dutchman roamed the waters, collecting the souls of those who died at sea. Witnessing the phantom vessel sailing the sky above the water was an omen of doom, a sign you'd never see land again. What sailors were actually seeing, however, is a superior mirage effect known as Fata Morgana. Light reflecting off cold water can be bent by an unusual layer of warm air above, making a normal ship look like a ghostly glowing ship that's sailing inside a wave or flying over the sea. Reports of poltergeist activity often reveal themselves to be the work of kids throwing household objects when their parents aren't looking. And purported haunted hotels have been busted, having employees perform many not-so-paranormal activities, such as flicking the lights on and off. But in 1973, the knocking ghost of Boise baffled police and frightened a woman and her daughter. The ghost could successfully answer questions, like how many people were in the room, by rapping on the floorboards. A knock so forceful the officers felt the vibration in the soles of their shoes. They couldn't explain the ghost in the crawl space. A news team came to investigate and noticed the ghost only knocked when the woman stood in a certain peculiar way. When confronted, she admitted an abnormal condition in her ankle caused a loud knocking sound when she flexed her leg muscle. The mystery of the knocking ghost was just a messed up ankle. Bloody Mary is a legend whereby staring into a mirror in a room lit only by candlelight and repeating the name will summon her apparition. Originally, this ritual was performed by a young woman hoping to see the face of her future husband, and if she saw a skull instead, it meant she would die before being married. Staring into a mirror in a dimly lit room can cause the Caputo effect, or strange face illusion, which distorts our face-specific interpretation system, really making it look like another face is in the mirror. But whether you think it's your future husband or Queen Mary I is up to you. The science behind understanding haunt events that don't have logical explanations like a bum ankle or an optical illusion is currently not so clear-cut. We know that magnetic fields can cause hallucinations that result in rushes of fear and experiencing apparitions. This has led to the suggestion that haunted locations may actually contain anomalous magnetic fields which induce hallucinations, thereby causing haunt events. But a lot more research is needed to prove this theory. Psychologist Richard Wiseman suggests infrasonic vibrations as a cause for ghost sightings. Infrasound is lower in frequency than human hearing, but can be felt in parts of the body. For instance, it can cause an eyeball to resonate, making it appear like a mysterious object is floating in your periphery. But when you turn to look, it's gone. An infrasound around 19 Hz can cause feelings of fear and shivering. But even so, magnetic fields and infrasound are external triggers, creating unknown sights and sounds that human brains then may interpret as coming from the supernatural. Because we're obsessed with giving agency to the unexplained, seeing human-like behavior in meaningless stimuli. Psychologists in the 1940s set up an experiment in which they showed people a meaningless cartoon of a large triangle, small triangle, and circle moving in and out of a box. Instantly, people created detailed stories about the shapes, such as the circle being in love with the little triangle, with the big triangle trying to steal the circle away, constructing a meaning for something devoid of one. So, with illusions, gas leaks, and inaudible sound waves, will science eventually bust all of the ghosts? Or just leave us alone in the dark with whatever is left out there? And as always, thanks for watching.